Good evening everyone. So in this video we are going to discuss about the Nyquist plot. We will see about some of the introduction about the Nyquist plot. So first, what is Nyquist plot introduction? The Nyquist plot, here the polar plot is the plot of magnitude of g of j omega versus space of g of j omega in polar coordinate as in the shown in the figure. So here normally the thing, it comes over horizontal and vertical line. So from here to the curve, it should comes over here. So in the Nyquist plot, normally what we are going to do, so whatever the steps we have followed over in the polar plot, the same step we are going to follow over for Nyquist plot also. Given the plot, the graph, we are going to make it in the same manner. Finally, the thing is, whatever the curve we are drawn over here, the mirror image of that curve we are going to make over here with the use of the Nyquist plot. Okay, so here the curve, it comes over here. The same thing we are going to make the mirror image over here. Okay, like this manner. That is the extra thing we are going to do the in this one, like a Nyquist plot. Okay, so in this figure we will see about r of g of j omega, and this is the g of angle of g of j omega, and imaginary g of j omega. So this is the real part g of j omega. Omega starts from 0 to and ends from infinity, so from here. Okay, so this is the line is called as g of j omega. Okay, so in the polar plot, the positive angle is measured in the counterclockwise direction. The magnitude is determined in the standard scale, and capture of the system behavior over the entire frequency range is single plot. And disadvantages of this one is the hides the impact of individed components of the open loop transfer function. The advantage is the capture of the system behavior over the entire frequency range of the single plot. Then comes into the next one. So here also some of the first order system, second order system, it comes over here. They given factors over the first order factors, 1 plus j omega t a power of plus or minus 1. So g of j omega is equal to 1 by 1 plus j omega t is equal to the magnitude 1 by, so root of 1 plus omega t. So finally pi is equal to minus tan inverse of omega t. So why? Because of c over here in the b term, it is omega t, and a is the 1. So tan inverse of b by a omega t by 1. So here why we are going to take the negative sign means because of it comes in the denominator. So denominator we are going to take a negative sign, and numerator we are going to take this a positive sign. Then comes into the drawing, imaginary and real. So the curve, it will becomes over like this manner. So the line, so this is the this one j omega. Okay, the angle for here to here, that is j omega. Okay, so this is for first order factor. Then comes into the second order factor. So here you can check over here some 1, 2, 3, 4 curves over here. According to this manner, the curves we should have to draw. So normally in the rectangular plot, it will be goes over like this. The curve, that is 0 to infinity. So the value will be the 1 by 1 plus 2 zeta j omega by omega 1 plus j omega by omega 1 whole square. So b also 1 plus 2 zeta j omega by omega 1 plus j omega into omega n whole square. Okay, so this is for polar plot for coordinate system. Next, this is the example for the Nyquist plot. So the problem they are providing is g of s is equal to 1 by s into 1 plus ts. So the presence of integral term as an impact, thus this impact, this should be considered like g of j omega is equal to minus t by 1 plus omega square t square minus j into 1 by omega into 1 plus omega square t square. So if you see the drawing, it will become the curve. It will be starts from 0 and ends from infinity. So from the distance from here to here, we can say take it as a minus t. So the Nyquist plot g of s is equal to 1 by s into 1 plus t of s. So the notes for the general system for physical realizable systems, the order of denominator is larger than the or equal to the numerator of the transfer function. Okay, the denominator is larger than or equal to the numerator of the transfer function. So this is the point we should remember over here. So type 0 systems finite starting the point on the positive real axis. So suppose it may be a zero system, it will start from the real axis and the terminal point is the origin tangent to one of the axis. Suppose it may be in the type 1 system, starting at infinity asymptotically parallel to negative imaginary axis. Also the curve converges to zero tangent to one of the axis. Then type 2 system, the starting magnitude is infinity and asymptotic to minus 180. So also the curve converges to zero tangent to one of the axis. Then comes for procedure for Nyquist plot. So express the magnitude and the phase equation in terms of omega. Estimate the magnitude and the phase for different values of omega. Plot the curve and determine the required performance matrices. Okay, so with that it get be over.